to special episode 214, where Julie meets Jodi. World-renowned medium Julie Genovese wanted to help with Jodi's case, as Julie had previous experience working missing and cold cases. We now have a final report comprising of consistent information from 10 years now of investigative interviews and almost two dozen mediums' input. That report can be viewed at EVPDiaries.com, and it is redacted to not interfere with ongoing investigations. There you can keep up with Jodi's and all our active and past cases. You will get to see Julie's spectacular reading compared to the years of information we've gathered. Just so you know, Julie knew absolutely nothing about Jodi and her case. In fact, didn't even know her name, didn't want to know anything. The reading you're about to see is completely raw with no background information, and you will see Julie's reading compared to the final report.
Very good to see you. Nice to talk to you. And I'm going to let you talk first so that I don't say anything that might...
I know that we have a female, mm-hmm. and I know that you told me there's a cold case, and mm-hmm. I know that you feel as though you may be communicating with her. Mm-hmm. That's all I know.
Okay.
I don't even remember her name.
Good.
So first I want to say, like, right now, as like I'm starting to like really settle in, I'm feeling super dizzy. I feel sick to my stomach. I feel like I can't breathe. I feel like I'm almost like being suffocated, but panicked at the same time. You know, like my panic is suffocating me, but I also feel like I'm being suffocated. I'm really having a hard time breathing. Did they find some of her belongings? Because I'm like seeing a shoe.
Very good.
I did feel like we were, it was dark.
So
she saw something she wasn't supposed to see. And she wasn't going to be quiet about it. And they knew that. I want to tell you that she fought. She was not going to give up until she had nothing left in mm-hmm. her. She did everything that she possibly mm-hmm. could. I feel like she played all the games. Mm-hmm. She played the compliance. She played the fighter. She played like mm-hmm. the sympathy. She did everything she possibly could. But this person, they had an agenda and mm-hmm. they were not going to back down from it. I also feel like this person was super angry, and I feel like this was targeted. This was not like random. She knew him.
Mm-hmm.
She knew him.
Can you tell me the color of the outside of the rug?
Blue.
Is your body still in the same place you showed me?
Water.
Look it up.
Oh my gosh.
Sounds like a plan. So.
Okay. As well, just now she was talking for hire. For hire, like this was like something for hire. Like it feels like they wanted to get rid of him for some reason.
When I was telling Scott about that the other night on the EVP, as I was telling it, Jared goes on the EVP. Yeah. Said me too.
So, you know, I got her a card because she deserved one, so.
she's hopped in the car with me. Since when you first emailed me, she hopped in the car right with me to check me out.
Okay. That's funny because I told her, I said, why don't you go check out Julie? She asked for you, by the way. She asked for you and she's asked for Cindy. She did. In a reading, I said, is there anybody you think we could talk to that could help? She said, Julie? She asked for you by name.
She said my name.
She said your name. So yeah, she asked for you.
Wow.
It's funny because I introduced Jodi to Julie just this morning.
Oh, okay.
And I told her, I said, look, I said, there's going to be another person coming in that I'm going to need you to talk to. In fact, I told her to go find her and get familiar with her because she wants to get involved in this. Yes, that's the Julie. There you go. Confirmation.
So, I know that we have a female, mm-hmm. and I know that you told me there's a cold case, and mm-hmm. I know that you feel as though you may be communicating with her.
Mm-hmm.
That's all I know.
Okay.
I don't even remember her name.
Good. That's good.
I try to be like, oh, I don't want to see that stuff.
Yeah, and I, mm-hmm. so basically okay. a female that was abducted.
Okay. I'm just going to write this down. She was abducted. So that we both know what we already know.
I
Did this happen in early 2000s and 90s or something?
Before that.
Like the 90s?
Oh, yes. I'm sorry. Is that what you said? 90s? Yes.
Yeah. I was like, wait a second. I feel like she's still missing. So I was confused by that. I'm getting hot. So this is we're in the zone.
That's it.
Huisentruit went missing in 1995 while on her way to work at the station. Since then, investigators on the case have come to believe she was abducted and was legally declared dead in 2001. Now in 2023, Huisentruit's remains have still not been located.
So
she saw something she wasn't supposed to see. And she wasn't going to be quiet about it. And they knew that. Here's a very interesting thing. I hear the words, he's dirty, he's dirty, he's dirty.
Did you
dirty.
Say?
I keep getting goosebumps. Girlfriend, I gotcha.
She likes to talk. And when somebody can really hear her, she'll get right up on you. She I actually.
I don't know if you can see. I'm
yeah.
Like because of this.
Yep.
Nope, I don't know.
But, yeah. She actually.
I feel like this particular. He, this particular him, has been dirty for a long time and has tried to bury things and hide things. And why, though? I hear also a word like a pawn. He's a pawn. Like, he is just, like, a piece of this bigger puzzle.
Yep.
But, like, why? I don't understand, like, where this corruptness is coming from. Like, why? Why her death and her situation is involved in this corrupt. Now I'm like seeing drugs.
Bingo. Bingo.
this guy was, he was launched, like, he was in part of it. He was either a mover or he did something. Ooh, she's telling me yes.
Absolutely. Yeah. Drugs.
Yeah. Like, he was part of that. He was part of that.
Mm-hmm.
The kingpin over here, he was like.
Yes.
This is much bigger than just her. There are others. This guy, he's got a lot of dirty people under him that he's just, you know, he's feared. He's feared. Somebody else knows about this and isn't saying anything. Right. I do feel like she was taken from one place to another to another. I feel like she was taken and kept and then kept somewhere else. And then she was dumped and hidden.
Mm-hmm.
I feel like she was moved. I got goosebumps. I feel like she was naked. I feel like she was just left to nature. I don't know why. I feel like she's showing me a baby doll for some reason. I'm seeing like a Raggedy Ann doll or some sort of doll. It's not a Raggedy Ann doll, but you know the dolls that are made of cloth?
Yes.
Okay, so I'm seeing something that looks like that. She's showing that to me. She's like holding it.
That's one I've made a note of it because it's very interesting. I think I may know where that fits, but okay. I don't know yet.
So sometimes the way that I do this is almost like remote viewing.
Good.
Where
that could come in handy for this.
Yeah, where I allow spirit to kind of take me through their experience so I can see through their eyes.
And that's what she did for me, by the way.
Okay.
And she seems to do that for everybody who gets involved in this. So she wants to talk.
Okay. I feel like around, off, I see a bench. I see some trees. I can hear cars behind me. I see cement and sidewalks, but I also see grass. I can hear kids. And I feel like I see like a flashing light, like if it's not like a traffic light or some sort of like light that flashes, like a sign or something. Metal that sounds like chimes. And it's really interesting. It's like she wants to cuss and she wants to be really angry about it, but she's like she just can't be angry about it anymore. It's like she's moved through that process.
If I might or get through that. And so I was very happy because can I give you her nickname without telling you her name?
Sure. Yeah.
So her new nickname that she earned is Smiles.
She's she's powerful, but she likes that. She likes how powerful she's gotten. She's like, I'll be the first to meet him when he crosses over.
Oh boy, you go girl. Yeah, mm-hmm. She will.
But something's gained from living every day. I've looked at life from both sides now, from win and lose, and still somehow it's life's illusions. I recall I really don't know life. gave my best to you. Nothing for me to do. But have one less cry before I leave it all behind. I gotta put you out of my mind. Please, child, stop living a lie. I guess I'm down to my last cry.
The falling leaves drift by my window. The falling leaves of red and gold. But I miss you most of all, my darling, when autumn leaves start to fall. Most of all, my darling. autumn leaves start to fall.